We want to determine an angle between 0 and 360 degrees that has the same trig function value as sine 310 degrees and cosine 310 degrees. Well, sine theta is equal to y over r, and cosine theta is equal to x over r, where x and y would be the point of intersection of the terminal set of the angle and a circle centered at the origin with radius r. So let's go ahead and sketch our angle of 310 degrees. Here's the initial side, and then we rotate counterclockwise 310 degrees. Well, this would be 270 degrees. So we need to rotate 40 degrees more, maybe somewhere in here. So the angle might look something like this. And notice how the reference angle would be 50 degrees right here. And then this point of intersection here can be used to determine the trig function values. Notice how the x coordinate would be positive and the y coordinate would be negative. And then the radius of the circle would be the length of this segment here. Now if we want to find another angle between 0 and 360 degrees that has the same sine function value of sine 310 degrees, notice how we need to determine another angle where the y coordinate would be the same as this point right here. Notice how the x-coordinate is not involved for the sine function. Well, we know the y-coordinate is going to be negative in both the third and fourth quadrants, so we need to find another point on this circle that has the same y-coordinate of this point. It looks like it would be somewhere over here, which means the terminal side of another angle that has the same sine function value as sine 310 would have to pass through this point here. So this point would have the coordinates negative x, negative y, but it's also going to have the same reference angle. So this angle here would be 50 degrees. So the angle that we're looking for that has the same sine function value would be this angle here, which would be 180 degrees plus 50 degrees, or 230 degrees. So sine 310 degrees is equal to sine 230 degrees. Now for the second question, we want an angle that has the same cosine function value of 310 degrees. Going back to our original point of x comma negative y, we want another point where the x coordinate would be the same as this point here. And again, notice how the x coordinate is positive. So the only other quadrant we could use would be quadrant 1. We want a point in quadrant 1 that has the same x coordinate as this point here. And that point would be somewhere in here, where the x-coordinate would be positive, and so would the y-coordinate. So the terminal side of the angle would have to pass through this point, look something like this. And again, the reference angle is going to be the same, and this angle here would be 50 degrees. Notice how the x-coordinate is the same, and the y-coordinate is different, but looking at the cosine function value, we're only concerned about the x-coordinate. So cosine 310 degrees would be equal to cosine 50 degrees. So this reinforces the idea of a reference angle as well as determining the sine of the x and y coordinates in a particular coordinate. I hope this was helpful.